One of these will be the eponymous Platinum Raven herself. He knows few details about her as yet, beyond the shining, platinum-haired grandeur of her seeming transcendence of everyday life. He feels he might kill, however, if this were necessary to bag himself a ringside seat from which to watch her upcoming emergence into being. The second character will be a creature of his unrealisable desire to live life with an intensity flavoured by self-destruction. He names this character Scorpio, after his own moon sign, a water sign, feminine and fixed, though as yet he knows even fewer details about Scorpio than about the Platinum Raven. Subsidiary to those two, there will then be a creature of his desire to wreak vengeance where deserved. Most games have several such characters after all, but the Platinum Raven will have the modest total of one, and Jaymi names him Amber. Amber will be off-centre, to say the least, but only the off-centre can supply a point of view that has any real interest, he reflects. The norm backs itself up without doing anything. Yes. Oh, and Amber will also be charming and lethal. So, there they are, it seems. His first three sexy beasts. Amber, the Platinum Raven, Scorpio. As yet, he knows little more about them than their names. But he catches furtive whispers as their silhouettes scurry past, shadows on the gauze screens hung across his ballroom, flicking indistinct across the scrims and the curtains, red-lit and purple-lit behind where he sleeps, and their giggles and their shushing hidden just around the corner at the end of the corridor, far down there, though they've not dared peep around the plaster of the wall to find Jaymi with their eyes, so they don't know what he looks like, not quite yet.